Hi everybody, I'm Mikel Corbi, keyboard connoisseur here at Digma, and today I'm going to show you how to configure your Digma keyboard with Basecore, our configurator software. The first thing you need to do is head over to digma.com/basecore and download the software. You can choose between Windows, Mac, and Linux. Then install Basecore and open it. The first thing you'll see is the keyboard manager, where all the keyboards that you have connected to your computer will show up. If you don't see it, then press Scan Keyboards. Once you see the keyboard that you want to configure, press Configure. The software will take you to the layout editor. There are three main sections in this screen. One is Keys, where you can edit the keys of your keyboard. The other one is Color, where you can change the colors of your keyboard. And then the other one is the Layers dropdown, where you can choose which layer you want to edit. Later, we'll explain how to switch and change layers on your keyboard. Let's start by editing some colors of our main layer. So I just have to select the color that I want to assign and then select the keys that I want to change. Let's change the WASD keys to orange and maybe my underglow also to orange. I just have to press Save Changes and kaboom. You can configure 16 different colors and tweak them to your liking. You can choose the different RGB values or even paste your favorite hex code. If you want to make changes in bulk in one of your layers, you can select a color and then select Apply Color to All Keys and Apply Color to All Underglow. You can also choose to apply the colors just to one side of the keyboard or one side of the underglow. Let's move now to our main layer and change some keys. For example, this space key here, I have too many spaces, so I want to assign it to something different. For example, delete. Press delete here on the key picker and then press save changes and the changes will be saved to your keyboard. Now this key here will be delete. Let's say that I want to change another key. For example, I want to have the exclamation mark closer to my fingers. No, I don't want to have it on my number one. I want to have it down here, closer, because I'm a very passionate guy and I want to use exclamation marks all the time.
Intense passion.
So I'm gonna select the slash, which I don't use that much, for example, and I will select the number one. But this would just send the number one. I need to shift it. That's where create a shortcut helps. If I select shift here, now this will be the exclamation mark. And you can do that also for shortcuts. Maybe this other space here, I want to use it for paste because I use that a lot. So I select V and then I add Command or Control if you are in Windows. This way here, I will have Command V, which is, does the same thing as Control V paste. And as always, just press Save Changes and the changes will be saved to the keyboard. There is many other things that you can change on your layout. For example, you can shift or lock two layers. That's the way that you can move through the different layers that your keyboard has. Your keyboard has up to 10 layers. Those layers can be navigation layers with arrows, or maybe a number pad layer with numbers. You can also have a layer with F keys or with media keys or brightness or whatever you want. I, for example, like having a layer with lots of symbols. To move to a layer, you have to create a layer key. Let's go back to this space key here that I assigned to delete, and I'm gonna make it move to layer 2. I have to select the key, then go to the menu that says layers, and select layer 2. If I press this key, the keyboard will move to layer 2. You can see that the underglow has changed. And the moment that I release it, I will go back to layer 1. But what if I want to move permanently to layer 2? For example, I have a gaming layer on layer 2 or a macro layer for editing pictures or editing video or for coding. If you want to learn more on how to use the Digma keyboard as a macro pad, check out this other video. To do that, you need a layer lock. To lock to another layer, just do the same thing. Select the key, then go to layers and check turn into layer lock. That will make your keyboard automatically lock into layer 2. It's very important to remember that you have to go to layer 2 and then assign that key to go back to layer 1 and turn into layer lock. That way, that key will bring me back to layer 1. I'm going to save the changes and I'm going to show you how it works. Now this key will lock into layer 2. I don't have to hold it, it's continuously on layer 2. And if I type it again, it will bring me back to layer 1. You can do that with any layer that you want. There is one more layer functionality that I find really, really useful. That is called One Shot Layer. I'm going to assign it to the keyboard and then show you how it works. To assign the One Shot Layer, select the key, go to the layer menu, and then instead of selecting Turn into Layer Lock, select Turn into One Shot Layer. It's very important that on layer 2, you assign that key as a trans key, that means as transparent key. So go to Keys and Shortcuts, and down here, you will see Transparent. Save changes, and now let me show you what the One Shot Layer does. If I tap the key, it will move to that layer, but just for one key press. The moment I press any key, it will take me back to layer 1. If I hold the key, I will be in layer 2 as long as I hold the key. So kind of like shift to layer that I showed before. And the moment I release it, I'm back to layer 1. But it has one more trick up its sleeve. If you double tap it, it will lock you into layer 2 forever. Until, of course, you press that key again. And it will take you back to layer 1. That's why it's very important that you assign a transparent key on that layer 2, because if you don't do that, this behavior won't work. Let's talk now about a feature that I like very much. We call it Add a Key on Tap. This feature lets you have one function when you tap the key and a different function when you hold it. Let me show you how you can configure it and how it works. You can do this for layers and for modifiers. Let's go to layers, and again I'm going to select that a key that I'm always changing, and instead of assigning it Turn into Layer Lock or Turn into One Shot Layer, I'm going to select Add Key on Tap. And I'm going to select that delete that I had before on that key. Now this key will do two things if I'm going to press Save Changes. If I tap it, you can see it doesn't change layer. It's actually pressing delete on my computer and deleting something. If I hold it, then it will take me to layer 2 while I hold. This feature lets you make the most of the prime real estate that are the thumb keys of the Tigma keyboards. Another thing that you can use Add Key on Tap on is on modifiers. For that, you have to go to Advanced Modifiers. Then select the modifier you want, let's say for example Shift, and then add a key on tap. Like before, I'm gonna add Delete. Press Save Changes, and now if I tap this key, it's going to behave as delete, and if I hold it, you see it's not changing the layer, now it would be shift. So instead of having to press shift with my pinky, now I can press shift with my thumb. It takes a little bit to get used to, but you can see how this helps you make the most out of these thumb keys or any key on the keyboard. Another thing that you can do with advanced modifiers is turn them into one-shot modifiers. For example, I'm going to turn this shift into a one-shot modifier. One-shot modifiers work the same as one-shot layers. If you tap it, just the next key will be modified. If you hold it, it will be a normal modifier, so as long as you hold it, all the keys that you press will be modified. And if you double tap it, it will be a lock modifier, so kind of like caps lock. If I double tap it, now all my keys will be capitalized. I will be very angry on the internet. And once you tap it again, you will be back to not being angry. And this works for any modifier you want. Let's skip macros and super keys for now, we'll talk about them later. And let me show you other keys that you can assign to your keyboard. For example, media keys like play, pause, stop, next, shuffle, volume up, volume down, whatever you want. And also LED effects. For example, if I assign this key to LED off and I press save changes, and when I press the key, the LEDs will turn off and on again. I can also assign LED next effect. So if I press the key, it will cycle through all the different LED effects like rainbow, this one is tracer, and then red, yellow, no, green, sorry, blue, white, and then back to your normal colors. But wait, there is more. You can also assign mouse clicks, and mouse movement and wheel movement. And then there are some settings for wireless, like battery level. So when I press this key, you will see the battery level of my keyboard and the Bluetooth pairing. So when I press this, the keyboard will go into Bluetooth mode. One of the multiple connections possibilities of the Digma arrays. Let's talk now about macros. Macros are strings of key presses that you can activate with just a single key press. For example, I can do a macro that when I press this key, it will say hello or hi teammate, whatever you want. Let me show you how you can configure a macro. You have to go to the macro menu and then press new macro. Let's call it hello and save changes. There's multiple ways to add the text that you want to your macro. You can just enter the text, so let's say hello, and press add to timeline. You can see here that the keys are represented. If I save changes, the macro will be saved. But I'm gonna show you other ways that you can add keys to your macro. I'm gonna clear the macro. If I press record macro, now Basecore will record everything that you type on your keyboard. So let's say hello again. And then you press add to timeline, and here you have hello. If you want, you can also do this, adding keys one by one. So I can add the H, I can add the E, the L again, and the O, and I have hello. You can do this with any kind of key, and also with modifiers. If you want to add shift, for example, for that first letter, you can press these three buttons and say add modifier left shift, and you will have the modifier. If you pressed shift when you recorded the macro, or you put the capital H when you type the text, the shift will be automatically put into your timeline. Now press save changes. Okay, our macro is created, but we need to assign them to our keyboard. Let's do that. Go back to the layout editor, select the key that you want to assign the macro to, let's say this command B that I had before, and now go to macros. In the drop-down menu, you will find the macro that you just created, in this case, hello. And you can see here what the macro does. Press save changes, and when I press this key, hello will appear on this screen. And now, let's talk about super keys. Super keys!
It's super key!
Dominic does this much better than me. Super keys are very special keys. They can have up to 5 functions. One if you tap it, one if you hold it, one if you tap and hold it, one if you double tap it, and one if you double tap it and hold it, which is a lot of double tapping. To configure a super key, go to the super keys menu and then select the key that you want to edit. Let's create a new super key. I'm gonna call it my media super key. Save changes. So select the key that you want to edit, let's say tap, and add the function that you want. As I want that to do a media key, let's go to media and LED, and for tap I want play pause. For hold I want mute, for example, and for double tap I want skip sock. I'm gonna save changes, and as before I have to go to my layout editor to assign this super key. So I will go to my layout editor, and instead of the hello macro I'm gonna assign now the super key. So I have to go to the super key sub menu here and select the media super key. You will see here what it does. As we said, play pause for tap, hold for mute, and double tap for skip. So save changes. And now this key here will do precisely that. If I do this, the video will pause. If I hold it, I will mute my computer. And if I hold it back, it will go back to my previous volume. And if I double tap, you will skip to the next video. No, I'm joking. Just stay here, and now that you're here, please also like, subscribe, and hit the ring thingy so you're notified when you will publish more videos about Basecore. And that's mostly all the functionality that you can have on Basecore. Of course, this just scratches all those features. Maybe you can watch this other video where Luis and I discuss about everything that you can do with a programmable keyboard. Nonetheless, let's check the last screens that we have here on Basecore. If we go to the firmware update screen, you can see that I have the 1.0.1 version firmware for the Rays. If there were a new version, it would show up here and I will be able to update the firmware of my keyboard. If I press this home button, you will go to the keyboard manager again. here, if you would have multiple Tigma keyboards, you should, you would be able to swap between them and configure them. And finally, let's go to the preferences menu. Here you will see preferences for typing, where you can adjust your preferences for the key on tab and the super keys. You can also configure your LED preferences that you can configure separately for wired and wireless. For example, if I drop my wireless underglow setting to the minimum and I press save changes, the light will go off. But I like lights on, so let's put that back. There we go. You also have LED timer off, which will determine how long it takes for the lights to turn off when you are not using the keyboard. If you have a wireless Tigma Race or Tigma DeFi, battery management is very important. You will find different settings here. You will see the battery of your keyboard at the moment, and you can also activate something that is really important, which is True Sleep. If you activate this setting, the keyboard will go into deep sleep once this amount of time has passed after the LEDs have gone off. This setting really helps extend the battery life of your keyboard. We also have RF settings, where you can select the intensity of the RF signal in case you want to use your keyboard farther from the computer. And in your advanced settings, you can select which one is your default layer. Finally, there are some settings that are for the application. So you can select if you want system colors, always dark, on light. Oh my god, let's go back to dark. Also select the layout for the key picker. This is really helpful if your input language is different from English. You can select Danish, English UK, Yurki, Finnish, French, many French, German, Icelandic, Japanese, Spanish, and even Spanish for Latin America. Then we have backups. Every time you make changes to your keyboard, a backup is saved. That is really helpful if you want to revert changes that you don't like. So you have to go to Restore Backup from File and select the backup that you want. As you can see, I have many backups because I change my keyboard a lot. So I'm gonna restore a previous backup from today. There we go. As you can see, that backup has no lights, and I will restore the one that I had before. And there we go. And finally, we have the Neuron Manager. This is useful if you have many neurons assigned to this computer, like I have, because I'm always testing different keyboards. But usually here you will see just two or three devices that are the devices that you own. And that's it. This has been a quick guide of everything that you can do with Basecore 1.5 and your Tigma keyboard. Let us know in the comments below if you want us to dive deep into any of these topics. We've already made videos in the past, so you can also check the playlist linked in the description. I hope that you enjoy your Tigma keyboard, and as always, you can find us at Discord, Reddit, and support at tigma.com. Bye!